Hello everyone, welcome to the class of Complex Analysis, Probability and Statistical Methods, 18 MAT 4-1. Today I'll be teaching a topic in statistical methods. Topic name is rank correlation. Myself, Dr. Madhura, Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, Sai Vidya Institute of Technology, Bengaluru. First we will see the definition for Spearman's rank correlation. A group of n individuals may be arranged in order to merit with respect to some characteristic. Suppose we wish to arrange n individuals in an order based on the merit with respect to some characteristics. The same group would give different orders for different characteristics. Considering the orders corresponding to n characteristics, two characteristics A and B, the correlation between these n pairs of ranks is called the rank correlation. So with respect to two particular characteristics A and B, we consider n pairs of ranks, and those n pairs of ranks corresponding to each will be called as rank correlation in the characteristics A and B for that group of individuals. The rank correlation coefficient is given by rho equal to 1 minus 6 into summation di square divided by n cube minus n, where n is the number of sets of data given for us, and di equal to xi minus yi. X and y will be the two sets of ranks given with respect to A and B. So we'll take the difference xi minus yi denoted by difference di. And summation di square into 6 divided by n cube minus 1 subtracted from 1 gives us the rank correlation coefficient. Note, suppose the ranks are not given, but a set of data for x and y are given. Then ranks can be written for the particular data x and y denoting by R1 and R2 based on the merit. So based on the merit, we can allot the ranks R1 and R2 for the given sets of data X and Y. In such case, the rank correlation will be obtained by the formula rho equal to 1 minus 6 into summation di square divided by n cube minus n. Again here, n remains to be the same, the number of sets of data given for us. And here, di will be equal to the difference between the ranks, R1 minus R2. Now we will see problems. Problems on rank correlation coefficient. Calculate the rank correlation coefficient from the following data showing ranks of 10 students in 2 subjects. So maths and physics are the 2 subjects that they have mentioned. The ranks are mentioned. A particular student takes 3rd rank in maths, he takes 5th rank in physics. Same way, another student takes 8th rank in maths, 9th rank in physics. Like that, the remaining set of data are also read. So we have 9, 10, 2, 1, 7, 8, 10, 7, 4, 3, 6, 4, 1, 2, 5, 6. So we have 10 sets of ranks given for 10 students in 2 subjects, that is maths and physics. We are asked to find out the rank correlation coefficient. We observe that in this question, the ranks are directly mentioned for us. Since the ranks are directly mentioned, we apply the formula for rho equal to 1 minus 6 into summation di square divided by n cube minus n. where n is the number of sets of data given for us. So here there are 10 student subject ranks given for us. That is why n equal to 10 for us. So let us denote the ranks of maths to be x and the ranks of physics to be y. We start with it. Let the ranks of maths be x and the ranks of physics be denoted by y. So with this we will frame the tabular column. The first two columns are for x and y, given set of data for us. And then followed by, we have to find out the difference d, di equal to xi minus yi, and frame the column for di square. So first two columns is for x and y. We have di difference is equal to xi minus yi and followed by di square. Let us fill all the values first. Given set of x and y values we can write down. I'll write on respectively for maths and physics. It is x, y, di is equal to xi minus yi, means the respective rows should be subtracted, and this is di square. So we have 3, 8, 9, 2, 7, 10, 4, 6, 1, Physics respectively 5, 9, 10, 1, 8, 7, 3, 4, 2, 6. We'll take the difference and write on this column. 3 minus 5 minus 2, 8 minus 9 minus 1, minus 1, 1 minus 1, 3, 1, 2 minus 1. Minus 1. Similarly, the next column will be di square. Squaring these negative values becomes positive. So it is 4, 1, 1, 1, 1, 9, 1, 4, 1, 1. We want summation di square. The sum of all di square values gives us 24. So this is summation di square for us. Now we will find the rank. We'll write on the formula to find out the rank and estimate the value. So rank correlation coefficient is denoted by rho. Rho is equal to 1 minus 6 into summation di square divided by n cube minus n. Here n value is 10 because there are ranks mentioned for 10 students. So this is 1 minus 6 into 24 divided by n cube is 10, 10 cube minus 10. We can use calculator and evaluate this, and this is equal to 0.8545. We observe again the rank correlation coefficient is lying between minus 1 to plus 1. So this is a simple problem based on the rank correlation coefficient which I considered. Now the next one we will take a different one. Second question. Three judges A, B, C capital A, B, C give the following ranks. Find which pair of judges has common approach, has common approach. So there are three judges who is giving the ranks, and we have to check which pair of judges, means any two judges might have the common approach while giving the ranks. So we have to find out which two judges gives the common approach. So A, B, C, the three judges ranks are mentioned for us. First, I will write down for A, 1, 6, 5, 10, 3, 2, 4, 9, 7, 8. For B, the respective ranks given by B are 3, 5, 8, 4, 7, 10, 2, 1, 6, 9. By the judge C, the ranks given respectively are 6, 4, 9, 8, 1, 2, 3, 10, 5, 7. Now, we need to frame the table relevantly. We will assume the judge A as X, judge B as Y, and the judge C as Z. The ranks given by judge A, B, C are respectively denoted by X, Y, and Z. Let the ranks given by judges A, B, C are respectively denoted by X, Y, Z. Let us assume this first. Then we will find out the differences. D1 equal to X minus Y, D2 equal to Y minus Z, D3 equal to Z minus X, followed by D1 square, D2 square, and D3 square. So we have to frame actually 9 different columns. So I have prepared 9 columns now. We will enter the data. So first 3 columns are for the ranks by judge A, B, and C. The ranks are denoted by X, Y, Z, followed by D1 is equal to X minus Y, D2 is equal to Y minus Z, D3 is equal to Z minus X. We have D1 square, D2 square, and D3 square finally. So these are the things that we have to frame. X, Y, Z are the ranks respectively given by judges A, B, C. Then we need to take the differences, each difference between any two judges. So the ranks given by the judges, differences are taken here. So we have to take X minus Y, denoting it by D1, say D2 equal to Y minus Z, and D3 is equal to Z minus X. We have to square them, D1 square, D2 square, D3 square. We'll be finding ranks. Three different ranks we are going to find out and check it out whose approach is maximum here. Okay, that is what the question says. So now we will find out. We'll first enter the values of X, Y, Z from the given data. Respective values of Y. And Z values 6, 4, 9, 8, 1, 2, 3, 10, 5, 7. The ranks are given from 1 to 10. T1 equal to X minus Y. Minus 2, 1, minus 3, 6, minus 4, minus 8, 2, 8, 1, minus 1. Similarly, D2 equal to Y minus Z we have to approach. So 3 minus 6 is minus 3, 1, minus 4, 6, 8, minus 1, minus 9, 1, and 2. The D3 column, that is Z minus X, will give us 5, minus 2, 4, minus 2, minus 2, 0, minus 1, 1, minus 2, minus 1. Now we will square these values and write on D1 square, D2 square, and D3 square. So minus 2 the whole square is 4, 1, 9, 36, 16, 64, 4, 64, 1, 1. Similarly, D2 square will give us 9, 1, 1, 16, 36, 64, 1, 81, 1, 4. And finally, D3 square we are finding, which gives us 25, 4, 16, 4, 4, 0, 1, 1, 4, 1. Now we need to sum up D1 square, D2 square and D3 square columns. Let us sum it up and write on. Their sum is equal to 200, summation D1 square, 200, summation D2 square, 214, and finally summation D3 square we will write on, which is 60. Now we will calculate a rank between X and Y, between Y and Z, and between Z and X. So therefore, formula remains the same. So this gives us rank between X comma Y will be the formula will be 1 minus 6 into summation D1 square divided by N cube minus N. D1 difference stands for X minus Y. So that is why we are writing down rank between X comma Y. Rank correlation coefficient between X comma Y we are finding. So that is why we have taken D1 square. So when we substitute and evaluate, this will be equal to 1 minus 6 into D1 square is nothing but 200 divided by N cube, which is 10 cube minus 10. Again, when we observe, it is 10 sets of data given for us because we have given ranks for 10 particular students. So 1 to 10 are the rankings allotted for them. So this on simplification gives us minus 0.2. Now we will find out rank correlation between Y comma Z, which is 1 minus 6 into summation D2 square divided by N cube minus N. Again, substituting summation D2 square and simplifying, we obtain the answer as minus 0.3. And rho of Z comma X, we will find out now. Rank between Z and X, 6 into summation D3 square divided by N cube minus N. So this again, substituting summation D3 square and simplifying, we can obtain the answer here as 0.6. So now we will conclude. We observe that rank correlation between Z comma X is maximum. Therefore, the pair of judges A and C have the common nearest approach. Therefore, pair of judges A and C, X comma Z or Z comma X as the maximum norm. That is why the judges A and C opinion are close to each other, have the nearest common approach. So this was a different one compared to the first one, no? So here in this problem, the judges ranks for three judges ranks were given. The ranks were from 1 to 10. Now the question was, which pair of judges has common approach? So how do we find out the common approaches? The more number of rank difference is coming, then we'll have to say that is the most nearest common approach. Now we'll see one more problem, the third problem which I would like to discuss, wherein the ranks are not given, a particular data is being given, and we will be allotting the ranks for the given data and then finding out the rank correlation. Find the rank correlation for the following data. Given data is denoted by X and Y. 39, X values are 39, 65, 62, 90, 82, 75, 25, 98, 36, 78. The respective values of Y are 47, 53, 58, 86, 62, 68, 60, 91, 51, and 84. So for the given set of data, the ranks are not mentioned. Now we will have to find or fit a rank for each one of the data. So there are 10 sets of data given for us. For these 10 sets of data, starting with the highest, we will allot rank. The highest data will have the first rank and the lowest data will have the last rank. Now we assume that based on the merit basis only. So it is something like, suppose a rank student have scored 90 marks in a particular subject, then it is 90 is the first rank. Or if it is 98, 98 is the first rank. Like that, we are going to allot the ranks for all of these. So first, we will write down the formula applicable for rank correlation. Rank correlation is given by 1 minus sigma 6 into sigma di square divided by n cube minus n. We'll come back to this substitution. Now we will prepare a relevant table. So I'll write down the values of X given to us, followed by its rank, say denoted by R1. Similarly, we will write down the values of Y given for us, and we will allot the rank for that, denoted by say R2. Then we have to take the difference between the two ranks, R1 minus R2, which gives us DI. Which helps us to find out DI square. X values and then followed by its rank, I will denote by R1. Then we have Y values whose rank we will denote by say R2. The difference I have to take DI equal to XI minus YI and then DI square. So I'll just write down all the given X values first. 39, 65, 62, 90, 82, 75, 25, 98, 36, 78. We will allot the ranks for all these. The highest scorer takes rank 1. So I will allot the rank now. So 98 is the highest one. So I'll allot rank 1 for that. 90 is the next highest. So rank 2 for that. Then the next highest is 82. So rank 3. 78. So rank 4. Then we have 75, so rank 5, followed by 65, so rank 6, 62, rank 7, 39, rank 8, 36, so rank 9, lastly 25 takes rank 10. Same way, we will write down all the given Y values and allot the rank for that. 47, 53, the respective values I am writing first from the given data. 58, 86, 62, 68, 60, 91, 51, 84. Now again, we will allot the ranks denoted by R2. Highest is 91, so rank 1. Next highest is 86, so rank 2. 84, rank 3. 68, rank 4. 62, rank 5. 60, rank 6. 58, rank 7. 53, rank 8. 51, rank 9. 47, rank 10. Now we will take the difference di equal to xi minus yi. Here it should have been r1 minus r2. The ranks are taken the difference. So it should have been r1 minus r2. So let me rewrite that. So di equal to r1 minus r2. R1 minus R2. We'll take the difference of these ranks. 8 minus 10 minus 2. 6 minus 8 minus 2. 0. 0 minus 2. 1. 4. 0. 0. 1. So these are the differences. R1 minus R2. Now we will square them and write down. 4. 4. 0, 0, 4, 1, 16, 0, 0, 1. Now we will sum up di square. Summation di square gives us 30. 30. We'll have to substitute all these into equation 1. We have already written the formula for rank correlation. So substituting in equation 1, rank correlation is equal to 1 minus 6 into 30 divided by 10 cube. N is 10 because there are 10 sets of data given for us, and this simplifies to 0.8182. We observe that the rank correlation lies between minus 1 to plus 1. So this is how problems on rank correlation are applicable. Hope you have all followed. Thank you for watching.